Hello, my dear students. So today we are going to discuss with one of the organic chemistry chapter, very important one, right? The name of the chapter is called as alcohols, phenols and ethers. So I think you might be knowing that alcohols, phenols are and ethers are nothing but the functional groups which are studied with respect to the first year, right, organic chemistry chapter. So in detail we are going to study with respect to each of the concepts of alcohols, phenols and ethers, right? So let us begin with the class, right? So first we will discuss with respect to the alcohols. So in this class we are going to study mainly with respect to the what do you mean by alcohols, what are its methods of classification, what are its physical and chemical properties, and what are the preparation, different methods of preparation of alcohols, and what are the uses, right? So let's begin with the concept of alcohols. So alcohols, how can you define alcohols? So these alcohols are nothing but the organic hydroxy compounds in which the OH group, that is nothing but hydroxy group, is attached to an alkyl or alkyl group, right? So whenever there is an attachment of hydroxyl group to an alkyl or alkyl group, that compounds we call it as what? Alcohols. Say for example methyl alcohol. So what is the formula of methyl alcohol? CH3OH, where R is your CH3. So if OH group is attached to R, we call it as what? Alkyl. So if it is attached to benzene ring, then we call it as what? R alkyl, right? So here we can see the example of methyl alcohol or methanol or ethyl alcohol, where OH group is attached to C2H5. So C2H5 is nothing but your R group, it is alkyl group. So if OH group have hydroxy groups is attached to alkyl or aryl groups or alkyl groups, then we call it as what? Alcohols, right? So alcohols are can be defined as what? These are the organic hydroxy compounds in which the hydroxy group is attached to an alkyl or alkyl group, right? So we have seen the example like methanol, ethanol, propanol, butanol, etc., right? So there are different examples we are going to study with respect to when we are discussing with each concept of alcohols. Now what are the classification of alcohols, or how do we classify the alcohols? So alcohols can be classified into different ways. We are going to study one by one. So first basis of classification is based upon number of carbon atoms attached to alpha carbon atom, that is first carbon atom, right? So first method of classification of alcohols is based upon what? Number of carbon atoms attached to alpha carbon atom, right? That is the number of, that is the carbon to which the OH group is attached, or that is called as what? Alpha carbon. So alpha carbon is nothing but the carbon to which the OH group is attached is called as what? Alpha carbon. So here you can see the example like ethanol, in which OH group is attached to this carbon. So this carbon becomes what? Alpha carbon, right? So alcohols can be classified into, first one, primary alcohol, right? So what do you mean by primary alcohol? So this type of alcohol has only one carbon atom attached to alpha carbon atom. So now see here students, it is very clear. If how can you call a alcohol as primary alcohol? This is a type of alcohol in which only one carbon atom is attached to alpha carbon. So this is your alpha carbon. To this alpha carbon, how many carbon atoms are attached? One carbon atom is attached. So hence this is said to be as what? Primary alcohol, right? So if the OH group is attached to the carbon, that carbon is called as what? Alpha carbon. So if the alpha carbon, if there is one carbon atom attached, then we call it as what? Primary alcohol. So here you can see the examples for primary alcohol: ethanol, isobutyl alcohol, there's nothing but your propanol, right? So butanol, etc., these are all examples for your primary alcohol. So I think it's clear students, primary alcohols are nothing but the alcohols to which the alpha carbon atom consists of only one carbon atom attached. Don't confuse here. So here also carbon is there, here also is carbon. No, the statement is very clear here. Primary alcohols are those to which only one carbon is attached to alpha carbon atom. So how can you define alpha carbon atom, or what is meant by alpha carbon atom? The OH group which is attached to the carbon is referred to as what? Alpha carbon atom. So hence this is an example for your primary alcohol. Then second one is called as secondary alcohol. So here alpha carbon atom has got two other carbon atoms attached to it. So you can see here, now OH group is attached to this carbon, so this carbon becomes your alpha carbon. So to this alpha carbon atom, how many carbon atoms are attached? So there are two carbon atoms attached. So hence this is referred to as what? The secondary alcohol. Now the example includes butane, toluol. Then coming for the third type called as tertiary alcohol. So to this tertiary alcohol, so you can see here that is nothing but So if the alpha carbon atom consists of three carbon atoms, then we say it as what? Tertiary alcohol. So example for this is commonly 2-methyl-2-propanol, or it is also called as commonly tertiary butyl alcohol. So on the basis of number of carbon atoms, the alcohols can be classified as primary alcohol, secondary alcohol, and tertiary alcohol, right? So this is the first method of classification of alcohols. Now the second method of classification of alcohols is on the basis of number of OH groups, or commonly called as what? Hydroxyl groups present. So these alcohols can be divided into following categories. The first one is called as what? Monohydric alcohols. Now dear students, we are classifying the alcohols into second types, that is based upon the number of hydroxyl groups attached. So under based upon the number of hydroxyl groups attached, the first method of classification is called as monohydric alcohols. Now as the name indicates here, monohydric refers to what? There is presence of only one OH groups attached, then it is said to be as what? Monohydric. So they contain only one hydroxyl group. So they have the general formula, that is monohydric alcohols have the general formula CnH2n+2O, right? So this is the general formula for monohydric alcohols. So for competitive examination also they may ask what is the general formula for monohydric alcohols. So please remember this part. So general formula for monohydric alcohols is what? CnH2n+2O, right? So now as the name indicates, monohydric alcohols are the alcohols in which there is presence of only one OH group present, right? So example includes CH3OH, there is methyl alcohol, there is ethyl alcohol, propanol, etc. So you can see in these all example how many OH groups are present? Only one OH groups are present. So hence it is an example for monohydric alcohols. Then second one is dihydric alcohols. So here as the name indicates, di, it refers to what? The number of OH groups are how many? Two. So such alcohols contain two hydroxyl groups or two OH groups. So for example includes glycol. So what is the formula of glycol? CH2OH, CH2OH, which are interjoined with each other, right? So this is example for your dihydric alcohols. Then third type called as a trihydric alcohols. So name indicates here, trihydric alcohols are nothing but the alcohols which contains how many OH groups attached? So there are three OH groups attached, then we call it as what? Trihydric alcohol. So example for this includes glycerol. So what is the formula of glycerol? CH2OH, CH2OH, CH2OH. So I think here 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, I think it should be CH, not CH2, it should be CHOH, then CH2OH. It is a little bit changed, dear students. It is not CH2 here, it is CHOH, right? Then this is the example for your trihydric, because it consists of three OH groups, right? Then polyhydric alcohols. So as the name indicates, poly, it refers to many OH groups are present. These are the alcohols that contain more than three OH groups, then it is said to be as what? Polyhydric alcohols, right? So on the basis of number of OH groups are attached, we classify the alcohols as what? Monohydric alcohols, dihydric alcohols, trihydric alcohols, and polyhydric alcohols, right? So based upon the first method of classification, that is based upon the number of carbon attached, we call it as primary, secondary, and tertiary alcohol, right? So we'll continue with respect to this. The next concept we are going to study is nomenclature of alcohols, right? That is IUPAC naming system. So how to name the, or how to name alcohol compounds, right? I think we have studied this in first year also, but for a glance I am going to discuss here with how to name an alcohol containing compounds, right? So nomenclature of alcohols by using IUPAC system. So first rule, as we know, that select the longest carbon chain, that is alpha carbon atom. So here the longest carbon chain here, it is nothing but CH3CH2, right? And since this is attached to alpha carbon said, so what is meant by alpha carbon? So if the OH group is attached to that carbon is referred to as what? The alpha carbon. So for this alpha carbon, the longest carbon chain will be, this is the longest carbon chain. Then second one is said, second rule says that number of carbon atoms attached in the chain, in you should number in such a way that alpha carbon gets the least number or minimum number. This rule you know that, right? So since OH group is attached to this carbon, this carbon alpha carbon should get the least number. So I start the numbering from this only, 1, 2, and 3. So hence the second rule says what? Number you should do in such a way that the OH group containing alpha carbon should get the least number. So since this is the longest carbon chain, if I number from here, this carbon alpha carbon will get 3. So I have started the numbering from this carbon, so the least number is 1 here, right? Then third rule says that then identify the hydrocarbon group and name it as per IUPAC naming system, right? So you know that second carbon atom consists of one substituent group, which is referred to as what? Methyl group. So hence we refer this one as what? 2-methyl. Now, dear students, the IUPAC rules how to name the compounds we have already discussed in the first year, right? Those are all the basic concepts you should remember. So according to rule, the first thing we are going to name organic compound includes prefixes, then root word, primary suffix, then secondary suffix. So prefixes mainly includes what? Substituent groups. So the substituent groups present over here is methyl group. So methyl group is attached to which carbon atom? Second carbon atom. So hence the name of this compound will be 2-methyl, right? And how many carbon atoms are there here? Root word is will be 3. So that is nothing but trope, since it is a single, right? So a single bond, propane. Then now replace the E in the end of the parent hydrocarbon name by all, right? So propane, this E you should replace by OL. Why? Because the suffix for the functional group alcohol is OL. So hence the name of this compound will become what? So here it is a 3-methyl, so it is a 2-methyl, right? So slight change here, dear students. It is a 2-methyl propanol, not 3-methyl. It is 2-methyl propanol, right? So first rule is what? Select the longest carbon chain containing the alpha carbon. Second rule is that you should number the alpha carbon in such a way that you get the least number. Third one, then name according to the any if the prefixes are present, then substitute the E of alkane by OL, because this is a suffix used for alcohol, right? So with this, I think this you are clear with how to name a organic compounds containing alcohol. Then common naming system, right? So I think this also we have discussed in first year, right? You also know this about the first year concepts, right? So the common name of alcohol is alkyl alcohol. Say for example methyl alcohol, the propyl alcohol, butyl alcohol, right? So commonly it is called as what? Alkyl alcohol. Depending upon the structure of alkyl group, prefixes N, iso, secondary, tertiary, or neo is added to the common name, right? So depending upon the structure of the alkyl group, right? So you know about N form, iso form, neo form, secondary structure, tertiary structure, everything. So I have discussed here some of the example. So N form, N is added when alpha carbon atom and other carbon atoms make a straight chain. So you see here, you can see here, this is your alpha carbon. So here alpha carbons and other carbons are present in the linear structure. So if they are present in the linear structure, then we call it as what? N form of structure. There is nothing but N propyl alcohol, right? So I think you are clear with what is meant by N form. N form is nothing but if the alpha carbon atom and other carbon atoms are joined together in a linear form, then it is called as what? N form. Then second one, isoform. So in isoform is added when the OH group is attached to this group, right? So if it is a containing of this group, then we call it as what? Isoform. So you can see here OH group is attached here. So here it is the example for your isopropyl alcohol. If there is a branching, right? So if there is a branching taking place, right? So then we call it as what? Single branching taking place, then we call it as what? Isoform of alcohol. Then last one, neoform of alcohol. If there is more than one branching, right? So one common example is quaternary carbon, right? So there, where you can see more than two branching takes place. So if that is the for example, then it is said to be as what? Neo form of example. So it is called as what? Neopentyl alcohol. So commonly I have discussed a general concept which you already studied in first year: N form, isoform, and neo form. Then coming with the concept of preparation of alcohols. Now, my dear students, these preparations are very important one, right? So please make through the practice with respect to each of the reactions involved here, right? So we are going to study now how do you prepare alcohols by different methods. So general methods for preparation of alcohols are described below. So first method of preparation of alcohols is from alkenes, right? So that is alkenes we are going to use, and we are going to prepare what? Alcohols. So by using alkene, by acid catalyzed hydration of alkenes, and according to Markovnikov's rule. So first method of preparation of alcohols is by alkenes. How? In the presence of acid catalyzed hydration. Now what do you mean by hydration? Addition of water to the reaction, right? So when water and acid are present as a catalyst in and which reacts with alkene, it forms what? Your alcohol, according to what? Markovnikov's rule. So here you can see the alkene which is used here is propene, right? So here this is your propene. This is made to react with hydration. So there is nothing but addition of water in presence of acid catalyst. That is nothing but your H2SO4 acts as a catalyst So when alkene is hydrated in presence of an acid, it results in the formation of what? Alcohol. So propene, propyl alcohol. So the same alkene will convert into alcohol compound. So remember students, this is very important one, right? So first method of preparation of our alcohols is from alkenes. So when alkenes are made to react with water in presence of acid, which acts as a catalyst, so hence it forms what? Alcohol. Now this reaction is very important students, because we are going to study one of the important 3 marks question related to this preparation, that is called as a mechanism of hydration. Now my dear students, the commonly asked question for 3 marks, right, regarding the preparation of alcohols from alkenes is, explain the mechanism of acid catalyzed hydration of alkene to alcohol. Or the question may be, explain the mechanism of acid catalyzed hydration of propene to propanol, right? So commonly either they make you specifically propene to propanol or alkene to alcohol. So the concept is clear, that is the, it involves what? Preparation of alcohols from alkene. So this is very important 3 marks question. So hence just we'll see how we are going to prepare your alcohols from alkene. So it involves a 3-step mechanism. So mechanism of hydration, it is a 3-step, right, mechanism. You have to write these steps properly, dear students. Some of the time you may be skipping with writing the protonation, that is plus charge, or arrow marks, right? So, or the byproducts, so hence you may be losing, right? So hence it is very important, what are the steps mentioned here, make sure that you are perfect with, right? So we'll discuss the first step of mechanism of acid catalyzed hydration of alkene to alcohol. So what is the first step indicating here? It indicates that protonation of double bond forms a carbocation. Now before I explain this one, this is the reaction which we are going to study with mechanism. So using alkene, I am going to prepare alcohol in presence of water and catalyst as acid. So the same reaction we are explaining with the mechanism here. So first method is formation of carbocation. So how it forms? Now this is your alkene. I have not written here the hydrogens. So here I have taken the alkene, that is nothing but ethene, right? CH2CH2, right? So here I have not written here, but you should write here the what is the atoms present here: hydrogen, 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 hydrogen. So when hydrogen is made to react with hydronium ion, now dear students, this is very important one. What is this hydronium ion? H3O plus. Now how did you get this H3O plus? See here, this H2O reacts with acid. Acid is nothing but H plus. This H plus reacts with H2O to give what? H3O plus. Why O plus? Because oxygen has given its 2 electrons to this hydrogen, so hence it forms what? H3O plus. This is nothing but your hydronium ion. So this hydronium ion is attacked by the double bond containing alkene. So hence what happens here? The bond between the hydrogen donates its electrons to oxygen. So bond between the oxygen and hydrogen is broken down. So what will happen? This hydrogen will get positive charge, and this will be your H2O. This is the byproduct which you obtain, H2O. What about this hydrogen? Now since the bond is broken down, this hydrogen attacks the position of this carbon. You can see here, now initially it was CH2, now it is CH3. But since this carbon has given the electrons to this carbon, so it has got positive charge. So hence there is a formation of carbocation, right? So the first stage of reaction of mechanism is what? Protonation of double bond to form a carbocation. Students, idu bahala simple ada. ಏನಂತ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಮೊದಲನೇ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ ಒಳಗ ಈ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಈ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ನಡುವೆ 2 ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಹೌದಾ? ಈ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ತನ್ನ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ನ ಈ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಕೊಡ್ತು. ಸೊ ಅದರಿಂದ ಈ ಈ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಹತ್ರ 2 ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಇವೆ. ಆ 2 ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತತಿ? ಈ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಕೊಡ್ತದೆ. ಎದಕ್ಕೆ ಕೊಡ್ತದೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ಈ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ತನ್ನ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ನ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಕೊಡ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ಕೊಟ್ಟ ತಕ್ಷಣ ಇದು ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಹೋಯ್ತು. ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಹೋಯ್ತು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನಾಯ್ತದ? H2O ಆಯ್ತು. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಯುವರ್ ಬೈ ಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟ್. ಬಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಹೆಚ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್? ಈ ಹೆಚ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತತಿ? ಈ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ಗೆ ಅಟ್ಯಾಕ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ಅಟ್ಯಾಕ್ ಆದ ತಕ್ಷಣ ದಿಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ದಿಸ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ C plus, that is it, but carbocation, right? So this carbocation is next in the second step 2 is attacked by nucleophile. So nucleophilic attack by water. So here you can see water, which we have seen in the reaction. We are going to take water here. So this is water. So again we are going to add water. So ill enagait nodri oxygen hatra add extra electrons ava, right? So I electrons in martu ee carbon ni kortu. So kortu takshana enaitu nucleophilic attack aitu. So ee full H2O group in ato e carbon ge attach ato. So this carbon consists of H2O, but oxygen has lost its electron, so it has got what? Plus charge, right? So in the last step, so this we call it as protonated alcohol group. So nucleophilic attack by water to form protonated alcohol. So last step olagi martivi deprotonation to alcohol, so to form what? Alcohol. So idravagi iruvanta deprotonation martivi, deprotonation andre removal, right? So remove maadi noktivi, we are going to form what? Alcohol. So here you can the same group protonated alcohol is again made to react with water. Water jothe react martivi, ಈಗ ಏನಾಗ್ತೈತೆ ನೋಡ್ರಿ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೈತಿ, ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ನಡುವೆ ಏನ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಇರುತ್ತಲ್ಲ, ಆ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ತನ್ನ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ನ ಇದು ಕೊಡ್ತು, ಕೊಟ್ಟ ತಕ್ಷಣ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಹೋಯ್ತು. ಬಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಗಾಟ್ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಚಾರ್ಜ್, ಸೊ ಆ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೈತಿ, ಇಟ್ ಅಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ದ H2O ಗ್ರೂಪ್. ಸೊ ಇದು H2O ಇದ್ದಿದ್ದು ಏನಾಯ್ತೀಗ H3O ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಆಯ್ತು. ಸೊ ಅವಾಗ ಈ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಏನಾಗ್ತೈತಿ, CH3 ಇದು ಆಸ್ ಯೂಶುವಲ್ ಇರ್ತದ, CH3 ಇದು COH, CH2 ಮತ್ತೆ OH. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ CH3 CH2OH, that is nothing but your ethyl alcohol. So from ethene we are going to get ethyl alcohol. So this is the important mechanism. So modalne step olaga alkenes reacts with hydronium ion to form carbocation. Second step olaga nucleophilic attack by water to form protonated alcohol. Third step olaga deprotonation of alcohol, right, takes place. So hence these are the three important steps mechanism for hydration of hydration process mechanism in presence of acid to form alcohols from alkenes, right? So ee reaction edkondo same ide reaction compound thori, right, the same thing will be obtained here. So you can solve this example, right? So ill yavada hydrogen representation maadilo you can represent here so that the mechanism will be clear to you, right? So this is important 3 marks question, my dear students. So hence perfectly practice this mechanism, ರೈಟ್. ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಭಾಳಷ್ಟು ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಈ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ಪಿಗೆ ಒಂದೊಂದು ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಉದಾಹರಣೆಗೆ ಈ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಬರ್ತೀರಿ, ಎರಡನೇ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾದರೂ ನೀವು ಕಾರ್ಬೋಕ್ಯಾಟನ್ ತೋರಿಸಲಿಲ್ಲ, ದೆನ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಲೂಸ್ ದ ಅನದರ್ 2 ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಹೆನ್ಸ್ ಈಚ್ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರಿಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾರ್ಬೋಕ್ಯಾಟನ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ವೆರಿ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್, ರೈಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ದೆನ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಮೆಥಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರಿಪರೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಲ್ಕೋಹಾಲ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಕಾರ್ಬೋನಿಲ್ ಕಾಂಪೌಂಡ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಮೊದಲನೇ ಮೆಥಡ್ ಯಾವುದರಿಂದ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ವಿ, ಅಲ್ಕೀನ್ಸ್ ಇಂದ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ವಿ. ಎರಡನೇ ಮೆಥಡ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಕಾರ್ಬೋನಿಲ್ ಕಾಂಪೌಂಡ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಎರಡನೇ ಮೆಥಡ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಬೈ ಕ್ಯಾಟಲೈಟಿಕ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಲ್ಡಿಹೈಡ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಕೀಟೋನ್ಸ್, ರೈಟ್. ಸೊ ಆಲ್ಡಿಹೈಡ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಕೀಟೋನ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತು ನಮಗೆ. ಸೊ ಆಲ್ಡಿಹೈಡ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ RCHO, ಕೀಟೋನ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ RCOR-, ರೈಟ್. ಸೊ ಕೀಟೋನ್ ಇತ್ತು ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ RCOR-, ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಡಿಹೈಡ್ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ RCHO, ರೈಟ್. ಸೊ ಇವೆರಡು ಇನ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ವಾಟ್? ಕ್ಯಾಟಲೈಟಿಕ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನೇಷನ್, ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಎ ಕ್ಯಾಟಲಿಸ್ಟ್, ರೈಟ್. ಸೊ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ಹಿಯರ್ ಆಲ್ಡಿಹೈಡ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಪ್ರೊಪೆನಾಲ್, CH3 CH2 CHO. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೇಡ್ ಟು ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನೇಷನ್. ಇನ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಯಾಟಲಿಸ್ಟ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ವಾಟ್? ಪೆಲೇಡಿಯಂ, ರೈಟ್. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್? ಕರೆಸ್ಪಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಆಲ್ಕೋಹಾಲ್, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಪ್ರೊಪೆನಾಲ್, ರೈಟ್. ಸೊ ಪ್ರೊಪೆನಲ್ ಈಸ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇಂಟು ಪ್ರೊಪೆನಾಲ್, ಆಲ್ಡಿಹೈಡ್ ಟು ಆಲ್ಕೋಹಾಲ್, ರೈಟ್. ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ಲಿ ಕೀಟೋನ್ ತೊಗೊಂಡಾಗ ಪ್ರೊಪೆನೋನ್, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಕೀಟೋನ್, ಆರ್ ಕಾಮನ್ಲಿ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ವಾಟ್? ಏನ್ಕರ್ತೀವಿ? ಎಸಿಟೋನ್, ರೈಟ್. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೋಡಿಯಂ ಬೋರೋಹೈಡ್ರೇಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರೊಪೆನಾಲ್, ರೈಟ್, CH3COH CH3. ಸೊ ಪ್ರೊಪೆನೋನ್ ಟು ಪ್ರೊಪೆನಾಲ್. ಸೊ ಆಲ್ಡಿಹೈಡ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಕೀಟೋನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್, ರೈಟ್, ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನೇಷನ್. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್? ಕರೆಸ್ಪಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಆಲ್ಕೋಹಾಲ್. ಸೊ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಮೆಥಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ಕಾರ್ಬೋನಿಲ್ ಕಾಂಪೌಂಡ್ಸ್, ರೈಟ್. ದೆನ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್, ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಮೆಥಡ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಕಾರ್ಬೋನಿಲ್ ಕಾಂಪೌಂಡ್ಸ್, ಬೈ ಕ್ಯಾಟಲೈಟಿಕ್ ರಿಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾರ್ಬಾಕ್ಸಿಲಿಕ್ ಆಸಿಡ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್. ನೋಡಲಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗೈತಿ, ಕ್ಯಾಟಲೈಟಿಕ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜಿನೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಲ್ಡಿಹೈಡ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಕೀಟೋನ್ಸ್ ಆಗೈತಿ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕ್ಯಾಟಲೈಟಿಕ್ ರಿಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾರ್ಬಾಕ್ಸಿಲಿಕ್ ಆಸಿಡ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಕಾರ್ಬಾಕ್ಸಿಲಿಕ್ ಆಸಿಡ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ RCOOH ಅಂಡ್ ಎಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಆಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ RCOOR-. ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗ್ತೈತಿ, ರಿಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಟೇಕ್ ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ಏಜೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಲಿಥಿಯಂ ಅಲ್ಯೂಮಿನಿಯಂ ಹೈಡ್ರೈಡ್, ರೈಟ್. ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕಾರ್ಬಾಕ್ಸಿಲಿಕ್ ಆಸಿಡ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಪ್ರೊಪೋನಿಕ್ ಆಸಿಡ್ಸ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಲಿಥಿಯಂ ಅಲ್ಯೂಮಿನಿಯಂ ಹೈಡ್ರೈಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವಾಟರ್, ರೈಟ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವರ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಆಸ್ ವಾಟ್? ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ಏಜೆಂಟ್. ಇಟ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್? ಕರೆಸ್ಪಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಆಲ್ಕೋಹಾಲ್. ಸೊ ಕಾರ್ಬಾಕ್ಸಿಲಿಕ್ ಆಸಿಡ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಟು ಆಲ್ಕೋಹಾಲ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಕೋಹಾಲ್ ಹಿಯರ್? ಪ್ರೊಪೆನಾಲ್. ನೋಡ್ರಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಐತೆ, ಪ್ರೊಪೆನೋಯಿಕ್ ಆಸಿಡ್ ಕಾರ್ಬಾಕ್ಸಿಲಿಕ್ ಆಸಿಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಆಲ್ಕೋಹಾಲ್. ಸೊ ಯಾವ ಕಾರ್ಬಾಕ್ಸಿಲಿಕ್ ಆಸಿಡ್ ತೊಂದಿರೋ ಅದರದೇ ಕರೆಸ್ಪಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಆಲ್ಕೋಹಾಲ್ ಬರ್ತದೆ. ಪ್ರೊಪೆನೋಯಿಕ್ ಆಸಿಡ್ ತೊಂದ್ವಿ, ಪ್ರೊಪೆನಾಲ್ ಬರ್ತು, ರೈಟ್. ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಮೀಥೈಲ್ ಪ್ರೊಪೆನೇಟ್, ರೈಟ್, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಎಸ್ಟರ್, ರೈಟ್. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಆಸ್ ಎ ಕ್ಯಾಟಲಿಸ್ಟ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಆಡ್. So hence we obtain corresponding propanol along with the formation of methanol. So there is formation of two alcoholic products, right? So in presence of when you are going to take esters, right? So ili carboxylic acids so mat esters they undergo reduction, whereas aldehydes and ketones undergo hydrogenation, right? So these two are also very important reaction, my dear students. Then the third method for preparation of your alcohols is from Grignard reagent. So what is Grignard reagent? Very important 1 marks question. Grignard reagent is nothing but commonly given with the formula RmgX, where R is your alkyl group, Mg is magnesium, X is halogen. So chemically Grignard reagent is alkyl magnesium halide. Notre very important formula ke adaga Grignard reagent do RmgX ant helbeku. What is chemically Grignard reagent andre alkyl magnesium halide. So il halide idu fluorine chlorine bromine iodine yavu bekaragirudu, alkali andre methyl ethyl propyl yavu bekaragirudu. So commonly we call Grignard reagent as what? Alkyl magnesium halide. So using this we are going to prepare what? Alcohol. So how do you prepare? We'll see here. It gives R group as a nucleophile to attack at partially positive carbon atom of carbonyl group. What is carbonyl group? CO group ian kartivi carbonyl group kantvartivi, right? So ill nodri idakke preparation of alcohol by using Grignard reagent hang martivi andre nodri idu aldehyde athwa ketone tantivi. Aldehyde and ketone andre eno? R C H O, right? That is nothing but your aldehyde. Ili H C O, sorry, CH3 C O C H3 thodre ketone agutta. So idu aldehyde agirabodu ketone agirabodu yaduna common reaction idu, right? When it is made to react with Grignard reagent, what is Grignard reagent? RmgX. Now idu idrola yenagutte andre the bond between the R and Mg is broken down, right? So break agagirutte illu kuda carbon matha oxygen nadve bond break up aagutte. So bond break up aadaga carbon tan electrons na oxygen ni kodtu, oxygen kodta takshana enaytu carbon tan electrons na kalakuntu. But R is gaining electrons, so hence this R attacks the carbon position. So ilu enaytu CR group attach aaytu, illu udiranta oxygen ge gain aithe, illu loss aithe. So idu MgX enaytu oxygen ge attach aagutte, so it forms OMgX. So idu addition product an kartivi now, right? So idu I think it is very clear, the bond between R MgX is broken down, the bond double bond between the carbon and oxygen is broken down, alkyl group attacks to the carbon position and MgX attached towards the oxygen position. So hence this product we called as what? Addition product. Now when this addition product is made to react with water, so water jothe react aadaga enagutte andre water is nothing but your H and OH. So OH group enagutte ee carbon ge attach aagutte ee hydrogen agutte Mg ile O ada, right? So MgX as usual ile O jothe enagutte hydrogen badutte, ee hydrogen ele bantu ee H2O olaga H group attached towards the this position and OH group attached towards the this position. So hence it forms what? Corresponding alcohol. So ill R CH3 thondre ill yadu kade hydrogen ittandre CH3 CH2 OH, that is nothing but your ethyl alcohol or ethanol, right? So this is very important students. Ill X iddalu substitute madbeku neevu, either chlorine bromine yavu beka substitute madabodu any of the halogen, right? So illu hydrogen hydrogen substitute madadaga formaldehyde agutta, athwa ill CH3 CHO thondraga this is nothing but your commonly alcohol, so that is nothing but ethanol, right? So if yav tonte depending upon that you obtain the corresponding product, right? So illu kuda CH3 tonandre we obtain CH3 CH2 OH, that is nothing but your ethyl alcohol. So these are some of the methods of preparation of your alcohols. So we have discussed in today's class what do you mean by alcohols. These are the hydroxy compounds, right, attached to the alkyl or alkyl groups. They are classified alcohols into based upon the number of carbon atoms into primary alcohol, secondary alcohol and tertiary alcohol, right? Similarly, the based upon the number of OH groups attached, monohydric alcohols, dihydric alcohols and trihydric alcohols. Then also we have seen the preparations from alkenes and important 3 marks question, that is mechanism of acid catalyzed hydration of alkene to alcohol. Then preparation from using aldehydes and ketones, that is aldehydes and ketones undergoes hydrogenation, catalytic hydrogenation, whereas carboxylic acids and ester undergo reduction in presence of reducing agents like lithium aluminum hydride. Then last one method is from using Grignard reagent. So by using this we have seen in this video some of the introduction and preparation of alcohols. So in the next video I'll be coming with respect to the properties and the physical and chemical properties and other part in the next video. So if you have any doubts, please go through the videos or you can just ask me right? So you can text me the doubts. I'll be clearing all your doubts, right? So hope with this you understood the videos. Okay. Thank you very much.